Hello students, today we are going to study the convolution code or the basic parameters of the convolution code. Convolution code is nothing but it is a block of encode digit which is generated by the one kind of the encoder. That encoder can be designed in the time unit depends only on the block of k message bits. So the k message bits is entered into the encoder and encode digit is output is from the decoder. So k message bits is entered into the decoder and the one code word is generated within the time. But the also it is depending upon the m minus 1 block of the message bits. Okay. So for example, this is one kind of the encoder M0, M1, M2 and these are the two states S1 and S2. These are the output state. So this is the one kind of the switch. We can call it as a single pole double throw. So whenever it is S1, the output will be S1. When this pole is shifted to S2, the output will be shifted. So you will get the S1, S2, S1, S2 kind of the output, right? Suppose M0 is indicated as a current message bits. And M1 and M2 is indicated as the previous two successive message bits which represents the convolution state. This M0, M1, M2 is nothing but the shift register or flip-flop. Flip-flop at a time for the single pulse or the for the current pulse, the flip-flop saves the one bit only. And for the next pulse, it changes its state, right? So from this equation, S1 is the combination of or modulo to addition of the M0, M1, M2 and S2 is the combination of the M0 XOR with the M2, right? Suppose the one stream is passed here, so which is suppose 0 is entered, first of all, suppose this is the state table M0, M1, M2. Okay, and this is the M0, M1, M2 and this is the state S1, S2. Suppose at the 0th pulse, so the state of the shift register of flip-flop is 0, 0, 0. So the output is also 0, 0, right? When first pulse, suppose this is the clock pulse, right? So for the first pulse, this bit is entered. Suppose this one is entered in the M0 shift register. Okay. So this 0 is shifted here and this 0 is shifted here. Okay. Depending upon this combination, so you will get the S1, S2. Right. For the second pulse, second bit is the 0th bit. So for the second pulse, this 0 is entered. So your message is 1010. So 1 is shifted into the encoder and after that the 0. So this 1 is shifted here and this 0 is shifted here. So likewise for the third pulse, so the third bit is again 1. So 1. So this 0 is shifted here and this 1 is shifted here. After the fourth pulse, so fourth bit is 0. So this one is shifted here and this 0 is shifted here. For the fifth pulse, the next bit is over. So the 0 is entered here. So this 0 is entered, shifted to the next and this one is shifted here. So in likewise, you will get the output, right? So the S1 and S2 is the combination of the M0, M1 and M2. S1 is the XORing of the M0, M1, M2, right? So for the first one, so 0 XOR with 1 XOR with 0, 1 XOR with 0, 1. Again that 0 XOR with 1, 1, 1 XOR with 0, 1. So it becomes 1. Again 1 XOR with 0, 1, 1 XOR with 1, so it becomes 0. Again 0 XOR with 1, so it becomes 1, 1 XOR with 0, so it becomes 1. 0 XOR with 0, 0, 0 XOR with 1, so it becomes 1. You can use the next pulse also, sixth pulse. So again 0, this 0 is shifted here, again this 0 is shifted here. So at the sixth step, you will get the initial states of the convolution encoder. Again 0 XOR with 0, 0, 0 XOR with 0, so you will get 0. Now you have to check for the M0 and M2, right? So 1 XOR with 0, so it is a 1. 0x or with 0, so it is a 0. 1x or with 1, so it is a 0. 0x or with 0, it is a 0. 0x or with 1, it is a 1. And 0x or with 0, it is a 0. So depending upon the state, you can generate the state table. So state table will become, so you can define the state A, B, C, D. So 0, 0, if M1 and M2, previous two bits are 0, 0, so state will be A. Previous two bits are 0, 1, so state will be B. Previous state is 1, 0, so state will be C. And previous state is 1, 1, so bit will be D. Okay. So k is the number of message bits. So for this case, we considered as a k is equal to 4, 1010, right? N is the number of encoded output bits. Okay, so the code word should be the of n type, and capital K, this is the small k, and the capital K is the constraint length. Define the number of shift register. Here the output will be the switch between the S1 and S2. So the output will be capital X. Suppose capital S is equal to X1, X2. So in this case, we can consider as a S1, S2, S1, S2, S1, S2. So you can consider it in the X also. And the code rate is defined as a small k divided by n. And the code dimension is nothing but n comma k. So in this way,